Sou o professor Zoltán Paulini e na resposta musical de hoje eu gostaria de abordar uma questão levantada por muitos de meus alunos, principalmente da escola Cantorum. O que é o canto moçárabe e como se relaciona com o canto gregoriano? Mas não sou eu que responderei esta pergunta. Eu convidei um dos maiores especialistas neste assunto, o holandês Gert Maessen. Ele, esse ano, 2016, lançou este livro lindo, um trabalho absolutamente valioso. E logo depois deste livro, ele ainda lançou um outro sobre o ofício de São Martinho. E ele aceitou o nosso convite em fazer uma palestra respondendo a esta pergunta e contando sobre o seu envolvimento pessoal com essa pesquisa sobre o canto moçárabe. Então, uma honra muito grande organizar essa palestra para o Gert Maessen. Ele fez essa palestra por videoconferência. Claro que uma viagem para o Brasil implicaria numa organização muito mais complexa. Resolvemos então com uma videoconferência transmitida aqui em Brasília para os meus alunos da Escola Cantorum. Então ele conta sobre a sua pesquisa, responde a essas perguntas e também responde às perguntas dos meus alunos. A palestra é em inglês. Eu fiz uma rápida tradução do principal em português, está disponível no blog. E tem alguns exemplos musicais onde ele pessoalmente apresenta algumas das músicas que ele reconstruiu. Então esse livro apresenta não só a resposta sobre o canto moçárabe, pelo menos o que se conhece hoje, né? É uma pesquisa que está em andamento, mas também apresenta partituras, são 50 partituras nesse livro, e o outro livro apresenta mais partituras. Enfim, é um trabalho que está gerando frutos enormes, um trabalho importantíssimo para a história da música, e acho que todos vão apreciar muito. Estamos muito honrados que esse lançamento tenha sido feito no Brasil para os nossos alunos da Escola Cantorum de Brasília. Então, por favor, divulgue e compartilhe com seus amigos.
In the core. Continue this interesting as the various sources and listening to other traditions. In doing so, in 1996, I developed a new notation for chant, the so-called Fluxus notation. In this form, the earliest notation of chant was placed online and the early notation itself is unreadable for us without the help of later manuscripts. In Fluxus, the early notation becomes readable while preserving the information that became lost in later notations. Fluxus notation in a suggestive way made it possible for me, my guru, to do more justice to the indications in the early sources. Therefore, our chant sounded even more like Eastern traditions. And now this should be the second video as an example.
Back.
Okay, we saw something of a 10th century manuscript and at the end also something of the Fluxus notation. So we started looking for a repertoire in the early manuscripts that was lacking in modern editions. We discovered that the most interesting parts of chant gradually disappeared from the manuscripts since the 11th century. The offertory verses. We just listened to one offertory verse, an example. Besides Gregorian chant, discovered other Latin traditions which disappeared since the same century. Ambrosian chant from Milan, Old Roman chant from Rome, Benedictine chant from southern Italy. And finally, Mozarabic chant from the Iberian Peninsula. Mozarabic chant is almost completely preserved in the same type of notation as the earliest notations in which Gregorian chant has been preserved. Unfortunately, the Mozarabic rite did not continue its written tradition. In 1085, the tradition was officially abolished and replaced by the Roman rite, its Greek chant. Therefore, Mozarabic chant is almost completely lost. It is only preserved in notation that was meant as a reminder. You can only read it when you already know the melodies. I was surprised that nobody had ever attempted to restore the lost chant practice with a computer. On the contrary, scientists stated that the melodies were irretrievably lost unless we would find manuscripts in which they were located, or where we could read how deeply notation should be interpreted. After several attempts to recompose melodies myself, I started to experiment with the computer. I could not believe that this would not lead to good, singable melodies. Today, I am convinced that nearly all lost chants can be restored in a computational way. The best way to do this, in my opinion, is calculate and sing. That was also the title of my first book on this subject, Calculemus et Cantemus. In this book, I presented 50 computational reconstructions of 10th century Mozartic chants. I do not claim I found the lost melody. I only claim that they correspond in all detail with our knowledge of the lost chants. The fact that we sang them all, of course, also means that they can be sung, and therefore represent some kind of music. Moreover, they are, in essence, independent of my taste, because they are produced by a machine according to a strict protocol. Although these reconstructions probably are quite different from the lost chants, we can sing them on the same text as 1,000 years ago, with the same melodic contours and tone density. Moreover, the melodic idiom is derived from the same time. Thus, we are able to get some nature, at least, of the past. Although I do not claim my reconstructions present the lost melodies, I am convinced that we can find these melodies by calculation and singing. It simply comes down to a continuous improvement of the calculation. And therefore, the experience from singing should be entered in the calculation. In every new publication, in sound or in print, we intend to proceed a little further. In our recent book with St. Martin Chants, the method has improved significantly. Also, the music has a more constant quality. It is fascinating to see the lost Mozartic tradition slowly come to life under my fingers. A tradition which, with its thousands of chants, must have been at least its rich Gregorian chant. Perhaps it even stood at the basis of Gregorian chant. Anyway, for the Mozartic tradition, it is also true that it provided the context within which many people in many centuries could live in harmony with the universe. Unfortunately, the irony of history connects the abolition of Islam with the suppression of the Mozarabic rite. Under Islam, Mozarabic Christians were free to practice their rite for many centuries. Their faith went even back to the time of Isidore of Sevilla and pre-Islamic times of late antiquity. For me, it is a great challenge to restore newer and better melodies for lost chants of the Mozarabic tradition. Someday, I hope to restore some complex chants of which I can say with certainty that they must have existed in the 10th century. Therefore, my method needs continuous improvement. I also need better criteria. In my recent publication, these criteria already are quite good, but unfortunately, now, they often show that most chants probably had nothing to do with 1,000 years ago. However, nothing obviously is too much to say, as noted earlier, we know for sure the text, the tone density, the melodic contour are the same. In addition, the melodic language is probably very similar. Perhaps these issues are much more important for the religious people than the things we are less certain, such as modes and ambiguity. My objective criteria already show that some reconstructions might have been close to the 10th century, and what is more important, some reconstructions are simply new. I would like to conclude with a video of short responsory for St. Martin, in which you can follow the original notation from the Leon Epiphany.
Confide.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your lecture. I will collect the questions, but I have a personal question for you.
Mm-hmm.
You search for harmony both in music and life, clearness and perfection, as we listen to your inspiring performance. These three elements build the beauty as Aristotle and St. Thomas taught. So, I have two questions about the beauty. Why did people and philosophers forget the beauty last century? And what is easier, was it easier for the Mozarabic artists to reach the beauty than today? So, there are two questions. What happened last century, and was it easier for people 1,000 years ago for reaching the beauty?
Thank you for this question. I think these are very difficult questions. We cannot look back 1,000 years ago, but we know for sure that a lot of things changed dramatically. We had no internet 1,000 years ago. We had no mass communication, no printing press. All these things did not exist. No. So the world looked very different then. And maybe the the singing of chant in monasteries and in churches was more like in modern time, thanks to your smartphone connection to the world, and the connection then was more with singing chant. Maybe that would be it. And the same changes in the modern world, I think, make these philosophical questions to the meaning of life more or less meaningful. But it's a really broad question, difficult to answer. Maybe this should be enough for this question.
Okay, wait a minute, I have a question here, but I need to understand the reading. Sympathy. This question is from Tulio. Would you be, in case you could bring this music to Brazil, would you do that, and in which way would you bring this music here?
Thank you for this question. Well, the most easiest way to bring this music to Brazil, of course, is by internet and by scores on the internet, I guess. So that would be the answer. That supposes, of course, that we have the music. When we have the scores for all kinds of chants, we could publish them on the internet or make recordings for YouTube.
Is that an answer to your question?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. I have another one. For reading early music, you also study music from other religions and other traditions. Didn't they evolve it over time, over the centuries, as Gregorian chant evolved? How can you find the common roots in such a dynamical system of evolving arts?
That is again a very difficult question. But I think there is a big difference in music history in the West and in the East. The West, Since Bach, we depend on musical scores, on reading scores. And in the East, reading scores is of no importance. You listen to your masters, you imitate them, and you sing chant in the living tradition. Not only chant, but also classical Indian music, for instance, or in Islam. It is an oral tradition where you don't and on notation. And that is an important difference, I think. And this oral tradition is also what was achieved for the chant. So the dependence on music reading, I think there's a big problem to come to the core business of Gregorian chant. Maybe an illustration, the later development of the Gregorian chant, the most popular Gregorian chants are from far after the 1000. And you look at the more earlier chants, there are much more similarities with Eastern traditions. The different, you can read that in the earliest notation, kind of ornaments or different ways to use the topics. You could get inspired by what's what you can hear in the East. But of course it is not really it is no proof that it is a kind of how to say that, kind of experimenting in musical archaeological, I don't know.
Okay. I will check other questions. Quem mais tem pergunta?
Hi. My name is Marcos. Thank you. Thank you very much for your lecture. And you you say the truth. The results you showed us are very beautiful. And I would like to ask you. You said that there are some examples of Mozarabic chant that are preserved. So we know how the melodies are.
Yeah.
And I would like to know how many examples, and if you have an example to show us, an original one.
Thank you for this question. Thank you. The answer to this question is not so difficult. I think already Rocco and Prado in 1929 published 21 melodies they found in southern French manuscript. And since then, some more were found. I think in all we have about 30-35 chants that are preserved. So we know the melody. And there are recordings made of these chants, and you can listen to them, of course. And that's also on a radio program I made some years ago. You can listen, and there are different ways of performance. One by a Spanish group, Música Antigua from Madrid, and another from a former Marcel Pérez from France. So there are about a few dozen chants preserved. And they're on the internet. I can give you the link.
I will ask for another question. Mais alguém?
Please.
Okay. We don't have any more questions. Everybody wants to express a thank you, and we are very much honored to have your lecture and have your music here and your answers. Maybe not everybody has understood the English, but I will translate, and I hope the recording was well, and we can put on YouTube. So I hope we can forward this message to people interested in Mozarabic chant. So thank you for this lecture, and I hope we stay in contact.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for the invitation and the invitation. And of course, there are more questions. Maybe another time. Thank you.
Okay, goodbye. Goodbye.